Koizumi!
Oh, Miss Hamada, good morning. You're as beautiful as ever today.
I beg your pardon. This lot is reserved for teachers.
I know.
It's ridiculous. How many times do I have to repeat myself? For the last time, stop driving your car to school!
But look, there's so many empty spaces.
By the way, how are the preparations for the show coming?
That curious?
I'll look forward to seeing your work at the show.
I'll work hard so that you won't be let down.
Oh, George!
Oh, hey, good morning, Isabella. You look as fabulous as ever today.
George, take me for a spin in your hot ride.
All right. You want to go to the beach?
Yeah, you're in your usual freaky getup, Koizumi.
You're really one to talk.
So are all your show preparations going well?
I suppose.
I see.
Good morning!
Miwako, how are you?
I'm feeling super duper.
Well, that's good to hear. You're looking cute as ever today.
Is something wrong?
It's nothing. I have a wild imagination.
If it includes tying you up, I can lend a hand.
Get away from Miwako, you perv!
Huh?
Good morning, Arashi. Are you feeling okay today?
Yeah.
Oh, I have something for you. Hey, Arashi!
What the hell is it? Quit bugging me.
It's the key to your apartment. Thanks for everything.
Huh? How come? What happened? So, did her mom drag her back home?
Not exactly. She moved in with me. We'll be living together.
What?
No way! Ah! Grody!
I'm so happy for her.
Oh, yeah. I'm at George's place. A lot happened yesterday. There was the modeling gig, and the thing with George. I can't do this. I'll waste away if I keep this up. Oh. This bathroom's bigger than my bedroom. I wonder what George's father does for a living. Ah, that feels so good. All right. What should I do first? There's no tag. I guess George made it. Oh. All the clothes he makes fit me perfectly. It's as if they were tailored for me.
Bon appetit!
Maybe George really is a nice guy. It's good. I'm almost done with the embroidery on the dress. I sure hope George gets home soon. Be some kept woman. At the very least, I have to earn my own keep.
How come you're acting so grumpy today, Arashi?
I ain't.
But you haven't said a single thing to me all day.
We've been together for 18 years. There's nothing I have to say to you anymore.
What?
But you've got things you want to say, don't you? Stuff you haven't told me yet.
To think of it, I did get a message from Caroline. It says something happened and the sheets got dirty, so I changed them for you. I'm really sorry about that.
I can't believe it. The bastards did it on my bed.
Would you please not tell Arashi about this? I'm sorry, Caroline! But isn't this great? Because now we can have sex at your place whenever we want.
You really think you can keep me happy forever if you just offer me sex all the time?
Huh?
Get real!
Why won't anyone hire me?
Time is on your side. You shouldn't become discouraged after only half a day of searching.
That's true. You're right. Thank you. I needed that, Isabella.
Here you go. Help yourself.
Wow! Oh, Isabella, this is delicious.
You know, you don't have to work if you don't want to. My old man will give you all the money you want. You just have to keep him company for a night.
Forget it! There's absolutely no way that I'm becoming your father's second mistress.
His second mistress? Nah, it's more like his 200th mistress.
You freaks.
The power of your love must be truly great. I can't remember the last time I've seen George in such a good mood.
Hey, where's Miwako?
Miwako was complaining of a stomachache, so she left school early and went home.
I see. I hope it's nothing serious.
It's probably just the usual upset. Arashi, did you guys fight or something?
It's none of your beeswax. And what the hell are you doing playing with those beads, anyway?
I find that rather insulting. I'm actually working here, making jewelry for the show.
Shouldn't you focus on finishing this dress first?
Yeah, well, I feel like making it now. Anyways, it's all done.
Hi, Miwako. How's your stomach feeling right now? Okay?
Yukari, would you mind trying this on for me?
Hold on. I'm in the middle of text messaging someone. Give it!
Here.
Huh? He put it on my ring finger.
It looks like it's a perfect fit.
It wasn't until really late that night that I finally heard back from Miwako. I wonder if something happened between her and Tokomori.
Yukari, you seem so distant. What are you thinking about?
About a guy who isn't you.
I see.
Did you actually expect that I'd be thinking about nothing but you all day long?
All right. Can I take this off?
No!
You know, I made that special for the show, so I can't have you breaking it before then.
Don't worry. I won't break it. I'll be careful.
It's so big, though. It's gonna get in your way.
No, it won't. It'll be fine.
You sure?
Well, that dream didn't last long. Goodbye, butterfly of my dreams.
Hey, what are you doing?
Thank you. I shouldn't stay up too late. It's bad for my skin, so I'm gonna go to bed now.
Okay, that's smart, and the right attitude to have.
Good night.
Yeah, good night.
I hope George comes to bed soon. Did my mother happen to say anything else to you?
No. I asked, is Yukari there, and the only thing she said to me was no.
That's all?
Yeah, that's all she said.
I guess you've given up on me for good this time, Mother. But look at me. I don't have a job, and I even moved in with a guy. I got a modeling gig, but that was just luck. There's no guarantee that I'll get any more of those jobs. Hey, Mom, am I moving forward, making progress? Or am I just trying to run away from reality?
It was a dream. But this isn't a dream, right? Yet somehow it feels more like a dream. George, wake up.
It's so big, though. It's gonna get in your way. What's the matter? You should be sleeping. You need your beauty rest.
It's nothing. I'm fine.
Yukari.
I'm never, ever giving up again. I won't run away this time, no matter how hard things get. Watch me grab a hold of the future with my own hands. I'm sorry. I really didn't mean to be late.
Don't worry. I just got here myself.
I know you must be busy. We could have done this on the phone, but...
Actually, I wanted to talk to you, too. Why don't we grab some lunch?
Sure.
What'd you want to talk to me about?
How do I say this?
Let me guess. Could it be that you're thinking about doing some more modeling?
Yes.
Okay. I will have the special. Make that 2 orders, please.
Yes, ma'am. Right away.
This may be presumptuous of me, but I'm actually pretty serious about trying to turn this into a profession.
Right.
But at this point, I have no clue about how to get started in the business. I mean, I'm at a complete loss.
This is perfect timing. A friend of mine just started a modeling agency.
Uh-huh.
I mentioned you to her, and she said she'd love it if you signed with her.
If I join her agency, does it mean I'll get to do modeling work?
Well, this is the way it works. The big jobs will typically require you to audition for them. I'm sure you can book the smaller jobs right away, especially because she's a smaller agency.
I'll do it.
That's great. She'll be thrilled. In fact, I'll call her right now. Hi, how's it going? It's me, Kako. Are you busy? Yeah, it's about Miss Long Black Hair with the legs that never end. Sure, I can ask her. What time? Are you free around 2 today?
Yeah, sure.
She'll be there. Bye. I'll give you directions to her place.
Aren't you coming too?
I'm sorry, but I'm finishing up my new collection, so I can't.
That's okay, don't worry. You're busy, I understand. I'm sure that I'll be just fine. Wow. You know, I never imagined that getting an agent would be so easy. I expected it to be a lot harder.
Really? Well, things are probably a whole lot easier for you than most because you're naturally well-suited to this job. Here.
Thank you.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
All right, let's dig in.
Let's. Thanks for lunch. It was great.
There's something I've been dying to ask you all afternoon.
What is it?
I love your outfit. Who designed it?
It's Paracus.
So it's one of George's designs. He's going to be tough competition for me in the future, but I won't let him beat me. Hey, stop laughing.
Thank you so much for all of your help today.
No problem. I'll be in touch, okay?
Great. Right now, the wind is at my back, and I feel like I could fly to the ends of the earth.
Okay, time's up. Put your pencils down and pass your test up to the person in front of you.
Huh? Where's Hiroyuki?
I did speak to Hayasaka's mother on the very first day of the exams. I told her that she could make up the exam, so she needn't come if she wasn't feeling well.
So as long as she takes the makeup test, she shouldn't have any problems then?
Well, no, but her grades just keep on slipping. Does she even care how she's doing?
It looks like a normal condo, but this is the place.
Yes?
My name's Yukari Hayasaka. And, well, Ms. Mikako Koda recommended me.
Come on up. It's the 6th floor.
Let's see. Makeup?
Good. Clothes? Good.
I love your outfit. Who designed it?
It's Pericus.
He's going to be tough competition for me in the future.
Feel free. Pick whatever you like.
What do you mean?
The room adjacent to the bedroom is a walk-in closet. You can pick and choose from whatever clothes you find in there.
Are these all pieces George designed himself?
Nope. Some of the stuff I bought.
Don't sneak up on me like that.
All the women's clothes you see in there, though, are my work.
Really? Wow. You could open a boutique.
Yeah, but I don't plan on selling any of those. I'm too fond of them. They have sentimental value to me.
Oh, this is so cute!
That sure brings back memories. I made that when I was in elementary school.
Really? You did?
I think I was in third grade.
You must have been a weird kid.
You think so? Back then, Isabella took my creations away as soon as I made them. I'm amazed this one even survived. Yeah, the craftsmanship on this is impeccable. It's one of mine, all right.
You really don't mind if I wear these?
No.
But didn't you say they had special meaning to you?
Yeah, they do, and that's why I want you to wear them.
Welcome. Come on in.
Yes, ma'am.
Like I said, I know he's an influential man, but you knew when you got involved with him that he was a worthless scoundrel, right? And yet you ran away from home and dropped out of school. Oh, hush! You brought this on yourself. He's not being kind. He's manipulating you. Are you kidding? No way. He is not in love. Why can't you see that? Quit letting him control your life. Anyway, I have someone waiting, so I'll have to call you later. Sorry, Yukari. I'll be with you in a sec. Oh, and one more thing. Yukino, did you talk to that pathetic junior about that thing yet? Oh, right. Oh, you're going to go yourself. Well, that's fine. I see. Okay, I got it. Well, I'll talk to you later then. Bye-bye. Thank you for waiting. I'm so sorry about that. I'm Shimamoto, the president of Treetop. Hello. Here.
Nice to meet you.
So how tall are you, Yukari?
I'm about 5'6".
Wow, you're not all that tall, are you? Why don't you have a seat? I'm going to go make us some tea.
So is 5'6 too short to become a professional model?
Huh? No, it's completely okay. We actually have a few models in the agency who are closer to 5'4".
But earlier, you said that I wasn't very tall.
Oh, you misunderstood. I just meant you were shorter than I expected.
Huh?
From the Polaroid Mikako showed me, I thought you were a little taller, that's all.
I see. That's a relief. Huh? What's so funny?
You want to be a model pretty badly, huh?
Of course. Otherwise, I wouldn't have come all the way out here. I don't get it. Why are you laughing?
Sorry. But how should I put this? It's rare to find anyone as passionate as you are these days, and with all your fire and earnestness. Oh, God! It's amusing! I like you. Don't worry, leave it to me. I'll make you a top model in no time. You don't believe me! It's written all over your face! You're so easy to read!
Oh, when I woke up tonight, I said I gotta make somebody.
She was gorgeous, much more beautiful than me. A powerful woman who was willing to help me. And through her bluntness, I felt like I'd gotten a glimpse of how harsh the world I was about to enter really was.
Oh, well. I'm so proud of you. Your famous friend.